Hey everyone, welcome back. Johnny B with Devslopes.com, and I got some more Mapbox fun for you. In this lesson, we are going to work on our getting the route showing as well as the navigation turn-by-turn interface in. So this is where we left off in the last lesson. We are able to tap on our map and set markers and enable our start navigating button. So let's go ahead and jump right in and make it so that we can add that route overlay, and then make it so that we can click on start navigating and show that awesome turn-by-turn navigation UI. Now that may seem like a lot, but with Mapbox, it makes it so easy. So let's get into it. First thing we are going to need to do is add a couple of dependencies into our project. We are going to need the navigation and the navigation UI dependencies. So I am just going to paste those in right here. And as you can see, we're using the navigation and the navigation UI dependencies versions 0.13 currently. If you're watching this in the future and there are newer versions, go ahead and use those. All right, and we are also going to have to bump down the app compat to 27.0.2, okay? And I'm going to sync that. There we go. And now we have all of the classes that we are going to need. So I'm going to jump back into Java folder, into our main activity file, and we are going to need a new variable. So let's go ahead and add that. We are going to need a navigation map route so that we can actually see our route. And that is going to be a of type navigation map route. Okay. And this is the class that provides the runtime styling for the selected route that we see drawn on the map. And we are going to call it navigation map route. We're also going to need a tag for some logs later on. So I'm going to say private static final string tag is equal to, and we'll just call it main activity. All right, so let's go ahead and create that function for getting our route, okay? So we're gonna call it right after, or right when we click on a map. So we are going to put that below on map click here. So I'm gonna say private void, and we're gonna call it get route. So to generate the route, we need to know where we're starting and where we are finishing. So we are going to put in a point and origin, and then point and destination. Okay, and so those are the two parameters that we need for this function. And then before I forget, we are going to call the getRoute function here when we click on the map. So I'll say getRoute, and then we will pass in the origin position and the destination position. All right, so here in the getRoute function that we just created, we are going to get our route, and we do that using the navigation route builder. Okay, so I'm going to say navigation route dot builder, and then it needs a couple of parameters. So I'm going to say dot access token. It needs to know what our token is. So I'm going to say Mapbox dot get access token. Then it's going to need the origin. So I'm going to pass in the origin as well as the destination. And then we are going to build it. And then finally, we are going to actually get the route. Okay. Mapbox uses retrofit under the hood for their network calls. So I'm going to say new callback. We're going to need a callback here, and make sure that you have the retrofit too. So I'm going to say callback, and we're going to be getting back a directions response here in the on response. And this directions response object has three parts to it. There is a code, which is a string indicating the state of the response. There is a waypoints array, if your route has multiple stops along the way, waypoints. And then what we are going to be working with, most importantly, is the routes array, which is an array of route objects ordered by descending recommendation rank. And there can be at most two routes, okay? So here in the onResponse call, we're going to be working with this response. And the first thing that we want to do is make sure that we got a response back, and that is not null. Okay, so I'm going to say if the response dot body is null, then we're just going to jump right out of here. We're going to return. And we'll also go ahead and log a message. So I'm going to say log.e. And we'll put tag as our tag. And then we'll go ahead and give the message something like no routes found. Check write user and access token. The other thing that we want to do is check to make sure that we have at least one route. So we're going to say else if the response.body.routes.size is equal to 0. So if there are no routes, then we are also going to log, and we'll say log.e and tag, and then we'll say something like no routes found. Now you may want to make a little bit more of a user-facing error handling right here, throw up an alert dialog or a toast, just so that they know that something is going wrong. But for our purposes right now, this is fine. And then we will also return. All right, so now that we know that we have at least one route, let's go ahead and grab that from the body. So I'm gonna say directions route is we're going to name it current route is equal to response.body.routes, and we will get that first one because we want the one that is the highest ranked for recommendation. All right, so now that we have our current route, let's go ahead and initialize our navigation map route that we made the variable for at the beginning of the lesson. This guy right here, okay? So I'm going to say navigation map route is equal to new navigation map route, and we need to pass into it null for the navigation. Then we're going to pass in the map view and the map. And then we can add our route to the navigation map route. So we can say navigation map route dot add route, and the route that we want to add is current route. Now, this would work, but we'd get a crash because we could be, after we tap once, we could be adding multiple navigation map routes. So what we need to do is have an if check. So we're gonna say, if the navigation map route does not equal null, then we are going to say navigation map route dot remove route. Else, then I'm going to take this line, cut it, and paste it there. And just do a little bit of cleanup here. I think that looks good. All right, so let's handle the on failure. So if we are unsuccessful, then we're just going to log it. So I'm gonna say log.e, and I'm gonna say tag, and then our message will be error t dot get message. There we go. All right, so let's go ahead and test this. If all goes well, we should be able to tap on our map, show a marker, and then view the route overlay. All right, here we go. I'm gonna tap, and let's see if we get a route overlay. Oh, there we go. Very nice. Let's see if I tap somewhere else. The previous one should be removed and a new one created. There we go. All right, wonderful. So now we got the route overlay showing, but if we click on start navigating, nothing's happening still. So let's go ahead and fix that. Up here at the top in our on-click listener, where we launch the navigation UI, this is amazingly simple. All we have to do is create some navigation launcher options and then launch the navigation UI. So we're gonna say navigation launcher options, and we'll call those options, and that is navigation launcher options dot builder. And then we need to give it the origin. So I'm going to say origin position needs the destination. So destination position. And then we can use something called should simulate route, and we can pass in true or false. And what that will do is once we start the navigation UI, it will actually simulate driving the route for us. So since I'm, you know, just sitting here in front of the computer and we would like to see some movement, so I am going to simulate that route. And later on, when you can change that to false. Okay, so then I'm going to say build. All right, and then final line, all I got to do is say navigation launcher dot start navigation, pass in our activity, which is main activity dot this, and then just pass in those options that we created, and we should be good to go now. So I'm going to run that again. All right, so I'm going to tap, get us a destination, and click on start navigating. All right, and here we go. Check it out. So we got our map going. I'm going to hold my device up to the microphone, see if you can hear the instructions.
Turn right onto 17th Street.
How cool is that? You have the option to mute the instructions, the directions. You can also pull up, let's see here, right below that sound icon. I'm going to tap here. And you have options for, you know, sending information to the Mapbox system. You can let it know that their road closed or that this was a bad route, and that will just serve to make Mapbox even better. All right, and check out everything that we get for practically free. You know, we wrote like 6 lines of code here. I mean, really 2, because this is all just a chained line of code here. And you know, look at this. You can do some really cool stuff here. If you tap up here at the top, you can see listed out the directions. And you know, just some really awesome stuff that you get practically for free when you are using Mapbox. All right, so this is the finished app. I hope you guys learned a lot, and that you will definitely consider using Mapbox in all of your future apps that require location. All right, so this has been Johnny B with Devslopes. Hope you learned a lot, and I will see you around.